house of prayer one more time. Amen. Oh, can't hear? Hasn't God been good? So we come today. I don't know about you, but my cup is empty, and I've come to be refueled this morning. Amen. Because when you come to CCC, church is not as usual. There's a different experience when you come to the Christian Church of Chester. Amen. Can we all stand? We bow our heads. Our Father and our God, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy holy name. Lord, we thank you this morning for another opportunity to gather between these consecrated walls. Lord, we come not no merit of our own, but we come just to say thank you. Thank you for your guardian angel that watched over us all last night as we slumbered and slept. And early this morning, Lord, you touched us with your finger of love. And this morning when I rose, Lord, I saw the bright sunshine. I said, thank you, Lord, for another day. Thank you for another opportunity to try to right my wrongs. And Lord, I come up to the house of prayer just to give you the glory and to give you the honor. Lord, we thank you for traveling mercies that you allowed us to get to this appointed place at this appointed time. Lord, we come this morning just to say thank you. Thank you for the man that's going to walk in John's shoes this morning. Strengthening where he's weak and build him up where he's torn down. Lord, thank those who have gathered here in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray that you might bless the choir. Bless the musicians. Anoint us in the mighty name of Jesus. Then, God, we pray that by and after a while that when we can't meet no more, we'll have a home for us somewhere in thy kingdom where we can sit down and rest from our labor. These and all blessings we ask in the name of the Father and of the Son and of his precious Holy Ghost. And our soul says, amen.
Amen. Amen. I have the honor to bring the scripture to you this morning. It's a little long, but I think it's needed. You may be seated if you want to. I'm going to be reading you Psalms, the 103rd Psalms, verses 1 through 22. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, and forgive not all his benefits. For forgiveth thy own iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who sacrifices thy mouth with good things, so that the youth is renewed like an eagle. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all that is opposed. He made it known his ways unto Moses, his acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous to mercy. He will not always chide, neither will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heaven are high above the earth, so great his mercy toward them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, far have he have removed his transgression from us. Like his father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. For he knoweth our fame, he remembereth that we are dust. As a man, his days are as grass, as a flower in the field, so he flourish. For the wind passes over it, it is gone, and the place thereof shall know it is no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto the children of children. To such as keep his covenant, and those that remember the commandments that do them, the Lord hath prepared thy throne in heaven, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, ye his angels in exile and the strength that do his commandments, hearkening unto the voice of his word. Bless ye the Lord, all ye hosts, ye ministers of his that do his pleasure. Bless ye the Lord, all his works, all the places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. It no matter, that's the Lord that blessed to read his word, but I have something to say after that. It's no matter what you go through during the week or what the devil throws at you and what hinders you. Remember that the Lord always has your back. He's always ever present in your life. You're not doing this by yourself. You're not going through this thing called life by yourself. When you think you're alone, the Lord is there with you. Rely and lean on the Lord at all times, and remember his words are true. Take his words to heart and commit them to your heart and your soul. His word is true.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We will now be blessed by the youth choir.
want to drive. Don't let him drag you down or put you on that ground. He's out there seeking who he made the vow. You gotta rebuke him, shake him loose somehow.
All right now.
Out there seeking who he made the vow. You gotta rebuke him, shake him loose somehow.
Good morning, Christian Church of Chester family. Another day to come together, live for God, and serve God. This time, we're going to come to the altar, come first with a heart of thanksgiving, thanking him for bringing you through yet another week. Some may have been easy, some not so much. Regardless, bring it to the altar. Right. We live in a world where our brothers and sisters of other faiths have had to become martyrs for their beliefs. We have to have the armor of God at all times, family. Heavenly Father, we come first to say thank you, Lord. Lord God, we thank you for another opportunity and the privilege of prayer, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for the families assembled here. Also those that have it in their heart and mind to be here but cannot, Lord God. We pray for the infirm members at this time, Lord God. We pray that you come on board, touch them right now, Lord God, and continue to keep them in care, Lord God. We pray for the families affected by tragedy right now, Lord God, the families of ours and all faiths, Lord God. The greatest of these is love, Lord God, and we pray that you continue to send your love upon us that we may continue to spread that love, Lord God. Lord God, we have special intentions this morning, Lord God, and we send prayers to the families still suffering from natural disasters, Lord God. We pray that you keep them safe, Lord God. Send your Holy Spirit right now, Lord God. There are families that are disconnected, Lord God. Bring them back together, Lord God. We pray for our community, Lord God. We know, Lord God, that above all else there is love, and we pray that you continue to bring us together and not separate us and keep us apart, God. Father, we have families that are still going through, Lord God, families dealing with loss, dealing with tragedy, Lord God. We pray that you spend a blessing upon the Sean family right now, Lord God. Bless them in their time of sorrow, Lord God. Continue to grant peace and understanding, Father God. Some may be at the altar and had an easy week, Lord God, and we thank you. And we rejoice, Lord God. And for those that are still going through, Lord God, we ask that you continue to encourage, uplift, and strengthen them, Lord God. Father, a special intention says to pray for a mother with a broken heart. Some of us have been there, Lord God. Some of us have been there. Some of us may be there now. We ask for understanding. We pray you bless that family with patience. We pray you allow us to open the doors of communication, Father God, that we may be able to mend fences and continue to have a spirit of love. We come with the spirit of expectancy, and we thank you for all that you've already done, and we know you're going to do, Heavenly Father. And we just ask that you continue to grant us peace. Every intention, spoken and unspoken, we pray that it is in order and it is in your divine plan, Father.
All right, now.
And as we depart, we just again end it the way we began by saying thank you.
Thank you, God.
The blessings spoken, the blessings unspoken, we pray in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. The Christian Church of Chester. How are you doing this morning? Give God some praise this morning. He is worthy to be praised. Amen. Praise God. If there's any others that need to be seated that are out there in the foyer, the time is now. Once again, it's always an honor to be here every single morning. Like Deacon Holman said, it is a different experience when you walk in here. Because we're looking forward to meeting and greeting one another. We never know what each of us have gone through this morning or even throughout this week. And the kind and generosity of our church family is always needed every single Sunday morning. So thank you all for being the wonderful family that you are as a Christian Church of Chester family. You never know how much that means to each one of us. And Deacon Holman is a perfect example of that. Now it's time for offering. And the Bible says, bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me now. Herewith said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. You are now in the glorious hands of the doorkeepers. If the outer aisles please stand. And like I always say, give God some praise while you're at it. Amen. Amen.
Center aisle, please stand. Center sections.
Thank you.
May the church please stand. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own, as we give of thee. Also, give the kids another round of applause as well. They're doing excellent, excellent. All right, now it's time for the welcome by Deacon Holman.
We still have some friends that are family and friends who are coming through the door. If I could give my salutations, first and always, we like to give honor to our Lord and Savior, who is the head of my house. And as Pastor Witherspoon would say, give an honor to Pastor Lilly, First Lady Lilly. To all the officers, members, and friends of Christian Church of Chester. Do we have any visitors worshiping with us this morning? It's all right to stand if you're a visitor. Thank you. Amen. 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 We are so glad that you chose the Christian Church of Chester to praise the Lord this morning, because of your present service has been so high up to now. We're so grateful. And if you're in search for a friendly church, your search ends here. May God bless you and heaven smile upon you. And don't let this be the last time that you come this way. God bless you real good. Amen. All right, deacons coming with our announcements. Have a blessed time, church. Amen. Come on, church. This is not church as usual. Amen. This ain't no ordinary service. We in the Christian Church of Chester. We not at one of these other churches in the city. We at the Christian Church of Chester. Amen. Hey, hey, hey. We praise God up in here.
Come on.
We got to show our visitors
all right
how good
now.
God has been. Brought
Come
us
on.
From a mighty long way. Put food on a table.
Come on.
I know God is able. You're at the Christian Church of Chester. You ain't at some other place.
All
You're
right
at the
now.
Christian Church of Chester. Church where God is our head. God is our all. God is our
Come
everything.
On now.
Where everybody is somebody.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Yeah, now we're getting into it. Thought y'all might have been tired from last night. But I got something to shout about. Every now and then, Jeremiah said, it's like fire.
Come on.
Shut up in my bones. Come on. Don't take me much to get started. Come on now.
All right now.
That is the last time I follow Joe Holman with announcements.
All right now.
Where's Joe Mill now? He will never again go before me.
Amen.
Because I got announcements. Thank you very much, Deke. Thank you, Deke. It's really, really difficult to follow that with announcements. Joe, never again. I'm not following Joe, man. I'm not. All right, first announcement I have, the Women's Fellowship team will be presenting a health seminar Saturday, November 10th, from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. All ages, women 18 plus, are encouraged to attend and to bring a friend. It's really important to bring somebody. Deacon Benji let me know that Zumba this week on Wednesday will be a glow-in-the-dark Zumba. Woo! They're going to do Zumba with glow sticks. I advise you, if you have never been to Zumba, I get tired when I just walk by and look at them. So if you're going to bring, you better come, you better bring your A-game. Okay, also I was informed by an anonymous deacon named Ronald Shaw, he didn't want his name mentioned, that the Walk Run Club is still active. It's not on hiatus. It's still active. They meet every Saturday at 7 a.m. unless otherwise specifies. They don't want to take off too long after Baltimore. You want to stay with the same program. Also, I'm mad at Aaron, too. He gave me this flyer. The first annual CCC Comedy Cabaret is Friday, November 9th at 7 p.m. at the Christian Church of Chester, featuring 2018 Church of Stars Network Comedian of the Year nominee, Kadriana Mack. Was that right? Kadriana Mack. Thanks, Aaron. So we want y'all to come out and attend and make this a positive event for this community and the church, please. So that's on November the 9th at 7 p.m. November 4th at 2 p.m., Delaware County Gun Violence Awareness Day of Action. Event program will be 2 p.m. at Sophomore Friends Meeting House Educational Forum and Call to Action. At 2:45, a witness walk through Sophomore Trinity Episcopal Church, 301 North Chester Road, Sophomore, and 3:15, remembrance service at a memorial to the lost t-shirt display on Front Lawn. 4:00 will be a letter writing and legislative session. I advise everyone to get involved in this. Guns, we see it every time we turn on the news, affects our city directly and our families. So we all need to get involved and take an active part in this. We should be standing up for what we believe in. We want the gun violence to end. We got to be part of the problem, part of the solution, not part of the problem. So I'm calling each and every one of you to try to attend this, please. It's important. It's November 4th. It's at 2 p.m. It will be hanging in the foyer. You want to see my man John Linder? He's waving them in the back. He's got plenty of flyers. And we're going to hang them up, and he'll be handing them out, I guess. Right, John? All right. See John Linder right after service. And everything else, follow according to your calendar you got for the month. Thank you. Be blessed. And it's now, Pastor, you want to say something, Pastor? Pass the corner.
Would you take this time to seat our remaining family and guests? Some of you may have noticed I was feverishly looking through my bag for an announcement that Annette gave me. I couldn't find it, so I'll make that announcement later. On Saturday, November 3rd, at 11 a.m., we will have a homegoing celebration for Joyce Shaw, a member who passed recently. We will, as usual, need all of your support and help, CCC. This is a large family. We can use all of the assistance that we can get. So if you would come out and assist us on November 3rd at 11 a.m., it would be greatly appreciated. And now we're going to have Genesis come to us with a praise dance.
hold one sec, what you want them to do. They're going to hand out sticky notes. Okay. Before we get started, the young people who are doing the praise dance this morning will be handing out sticky post-it notes. And they want you to write one word on there regarding how you got over and made it through. All of us have gotten over and made it through something. So when they hand you a sticky note, just write on there how you got over and how you made it through.
So much pressure, heartache, so much pain.
Yeah.
I've been broken into pieces, maybe more. Hey. And some nights I made my bed right on the floor. Woo. The enemy really tried to take me out. Hey. Hit me with his best shot, knocked me down.
Hey, come on. Come on.
But I'm still standing after all I've been through. Because of you.
Amen. right now. Amen. Now, I have, in 25 years, take me down just a little bit, in 25 years, have never, ever refused to give a lesson. In 25 years, every time I've stood up, I've given a lesson. Some you've liked, some you haven't. But I have never, ever refused to give a lesson. Anybody in here ever remember me refusing to give a lesson on Sunday morning? No? I am refusing to give a lesson this morning until you start giving God some praise. He brought you through too much. We've been through too much. He brought you through too much. You need to give God some praise. If you don't have anything else to praise Him for, you ought to praise Him because He woke you up this morning and started you on your way. Every time I wake up in the morning, I have to say thank you, God, because He did not have to do it, but He touched me one more time with His divine finger of love, awakened me to see another day that I had not seen before. He blessed me with another opportunity to correct the things I messed up yesterday. I have to give Him some praise. I don't know how you can not praise Him for the things He has done. Some of you have children. He watched over your children night and day. You ought to praise Him this morning. You ought to say, thank you, God, for all you've done for me. He brought you through when you didn't have that job. You made it somehow. It wasn't because you were so smart or because you were so wise. It's because you serve an all-wise God. And He can make a way out of no way. Thank you. Beginning to feel like CCC now. One of the deacons asked me this morning, he said, is it dragging a little this morning, Pastor, or is it me? It's dragging. I'm gonna drag you right along with me, because I'm feeling pretty good right about now. He's done too much for me to sit down on Him on a Sunday morning. I could have stayed at home in bed and been quiet. When I come out to the house of God, I come out to give Him the praise. I come out to give Him all the honor, all the glory. Y'all getting close now. I might do a lesson, y'all. It could happen. Thank you. Woo! Thank you, thank you, thank you. He said something somewhere about a lukewarm, he'd spew them out. I don't want a lukewarm church. I want a church that's on fire for God, that knows what God has done for them. If you want a lukewarm church, I got something I can name for you, but I won't. See, the old Ed Lilly pastor, he would have named them all, but I'm not going to name them this morning. I just don't want you to become a lukewarm church. You ought to come in here on fire for God. And I want you to tell all of those Eagles fans that stayed home because the Eagles are playing across the pond, and you know who they are. Just look at the seats that are empty and you can tell who they are. We're going to take those seats away next week. They're going to have to stand in the back. It's been a good day already. When He woke me up this morning, it was a good day. You're going to go through some trials and tribulations in life. But when you get a chance to come out and thank God for bringing you through, come on out here. So what are we going to talk about this morning? Well, first off, we have to rearrange all of you. No, I'm going to have to rearrange a few of you. I'm going to have to rearrange the
first pew, Cheryl Ann, and I'm going to have to rearrange the second pew on both sides in the middle and have you find seating elsewhere. But seating is going to free up real quick now because I want everybody in the family that's with the baby dedication this morning, I want you to take this empty space up here this morning. So they're going to make some room for you. I want all of you to come forward and take this space up here this morning. Today is a special day. We get to dedicate a baby back to the Lord. So we're going to do that this morning, and I want them to come forward. And just either side, it doesn't matter which side. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Anybody else? Everybody always hate that front pew. Woo! Can't sell it. Can't give it away. The lesson just for a few minutes this morning is don't hinder the children. Don't hinder the children. But we're going to have to work through something before we get down that far. And I would like for you to turn, if you would, in your Bibles to the 10th chapter of Mark. The 10th chapter of Mark, beginning at the first verse. And he arose from thence, and cometh unto the coast of Judea by the farther side of Jordan. And the people resort unto him again. And as he was wont, he taught them again. And the Pharisees came to him and asked him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife? Tempting him. And he answered and said unto them, what did Moses command you? And they said, Moses suffered to write a bill of divorcement and to put her away. And Jesus answered and said unto them, for the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this precept. But from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife. And they twain shall be one flesh. So then they were no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. And in the house his disciples asked him again of the same matter. And he saith unto them, whosoever shall put his wife away and marry another committeth adultery against her. And if a woman shall put away her husband and be married to another, she committeth adultery. And I know you're sitting there saying, what in the world does that have to do with don't hinder the children? Well, I'm going to see if I can make it plain. God has ordered things in the world. It's man that changes the order of things. From the beginning of time, the sun has been rising in the east and going down in the west. From the beginning of time, and most of you have experienced it in your lifetime, in the winter, you hear the geese flying over, heading to the south. They don't have a radar gun, they don't have a radar GPS system, but they will land in the same pond every year. How does that happen? Everything God ordered, except for man, has followed what he set up. If you look around, you'll notice that the moon still comes up at night. It does not get confused and want to outshine the sun in the day. However, I've seen the moon up in the sky in the day. Anybody ever see that? The first time I saw it, I thought I'd been knocked out in football. Because I got hit so hard, I was laying on my back, and it was daytime, and I could see the moon. Well, that was the first time I'd seen the moon in the daytime. But I have learned that the moon does show up in the daytime. I don't know why or how, but it has never been able to outshine the sun. Not yet, not one time. Everything God has ordered follows his orders except for man. Now then, the disciples, they've finally gotten settled. Let me read the verse for you. I think it's verse 10. And in the house, his disciples asked him again the same matter. And he went through that. Now, picture this. He had been dealing with the Pharisees all day. He had gotten through with them, and now they find themselves in a house. And while they're in the house, the disciples ask him the same question that the Pharisees had asked him. And I know they were all tired of dealing with the crowd that day. And I don't know whether it was a knock on the door or how the people were bringing the children to him, but people started bringing children to Jesus so that he could touch them. The disciples rebuked him, said, get away, go away. I think they might have been saying something like, you know, we've had a long day, and he doesn't have time to fool with kids now. He's been fooling with too many of you adults all day long, so you parents take these kids back home, go away. So they rebuked them. They were only bringing the children to Jesus that he might touch them. That's all they wanted, was that Jesus might touch them. Wouldn't it be nice if Jesus could touch your child? Wouldn't it be a blessing if there were a way that Jesus could touch your child? If I'd been back there then, I certainly would have brought Brandon, Courtney, and Destiny. Would have said, hey, touch him. I know why you're looking at me like that, because some of you are touched. I don't know exactly what you are touched with. Some of you are touched with a little overeating habit. Some are touched since that boyfriend, girlfriend left you, you lost your mind. But these folk were bringing their children to Jesus that he might touch them. Jesus says to them, let's read on. And they brought young children to him that he should touch them. And his disciples rebuked those that brought them. But Jesus, when he saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. People, there are several times in the Bible where Jesus really gets angry. This was one of them. In my early pastorate, a lady came to me and told me, Pastor, you were pretty angry the other day. And Jesus didn't get angry. I said, I beg to differ with you. And I'm going to follow Jesus every step of the way. And when it's time for me to get angry, I'm going to get angry. Jesus was displeased that they were rebuking and sending the families and the children away. All they had come for was that they might be touched. And he says, of such is the kingdom of heaven. What does that mean? What's a child like? What does that mean? A child is dependent. Anybody ever raise a child from birth? They think that they are the universe. They think the whole universe has to support them. They cry when they want milk. They get wet, they cry. They mess up their diapers, they cry. You don't give them enough attention, they cry. You don't feed them on time, they cry. They are very, very dependent. And the scripture says, of such is the kingdom of heaven. Well, what else does a child do? Very needy. Any of y'all ever raised any needy children? And some of your children are 45 years old and still just as needy as they were when they were two. Always in your pocket. Always mama, daddy this, mama, daddy that. Some needy, needy folk. Well, that's not bad, because Christ said, of such is the kingdom of heaven. That you have to be needy to get there. And the final thing is children are humble. They're going to say exactly what comes to their mind. Have you ever heard a child tell you, Pastor, you're getting fat? they're just, you know, they're just normal. They'll do what comes to their mind. You remember DJ, the little fellow that comes up here? He's not showing out. He's just humble, and he's in the Spirit, and he's doing what the Spirit is leading him to do. And the Scripture says, of such is the kingdom of heaven. Now, when he gets older and gets in a choir, maybe he will do that step at the same time on the same song every time they sing that song. Because you've learned that if you do that, after a while, somebody's going to wave their hand. That's phony. But little children aren't phony. He comes up in here. He looks at the choir. It's almost like he's directing the choir. He's really into it. But he's doing it with a humble spirit. He's not doing it with Joe. I don't think he even recognized y'all in the room. He just recognized the choir is up in the room and what the Spirit is leading him to do. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Dependent, needy, and humble. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. First, they were touched. Some of y'all sitting right in here this morning need to be touched by Jesus. Let me say that again. Some of y'all sitting right in here this morning needs to be touched by Jesus. As a matter of fact, on some days I need him to touch me. You know when that other self come out? And most of us can feel it, we can tell it, when that other self start coming out, we need to be touched by Jesus. You get on your job and you think your boss lost his or her mind, and then you go losing your mind. At that point in time, you need to be touched by Jesus. In order to get to heaven, you're gonna have to depend on Jesus. Most of us depend on our own self and our own resources, and we think we can get there doing it our way. You need to be dependent on Jesus. You need to depend on him for your every move. Do you know you could not even breathe without his say-so? You couldn't have even gotten out of bed without his say-so this morning? I don't care how much emu you rub on that knee. Unless Jesus tell you to move, it ain't gonna move. I don't care how much you take out of that medicine cabinet. It's not going to make a difference because the healing comes through him, not through the doctor. I know what I'm talking. We need to learn to be like a child and be dependent on him. We need to be needy, where we know that everything I am, everything I ever will be, comes from him. I counsel young children, young men especially, all the time. Do not put all of your hopes on making it to the NFL. Do not put all of your hope on making it to the NBA. Do not do that, because you're one injury away from not making it anyhow. And guess what? Out of the thousands of young men that try, only a handful make it. So you need to learn how to depend on God, then he will supply your every need. I tell the young men as well, just because God gave you talent, you need to be humble. If you make a touchdown, just lay that ball down in the end zone. Because you've already got what you wanted. That was the cross that goal line. Once you get across that, if I ever make it to heaven, I'm not going to spike the ball. I'm going to be so happy to get there. I'm just going to woo for a little while. Y'all going to know when I get there. If y'all don't know when nobody else get there, when I get inside those pearly gates, I am going to shout like I've never shouted before. I'm not going to dance for you. I'm going to dance like David danced, because I made it in. I'm going to dance all night But you, I know you're saying, Pastor, but you can't dance. I'll dance then. You let me get up there. And if you want to see me dance, just make it to heaven with me. We need to become needy, dependent, and humble. So when you get to heaven, don't be up there trying to find the gold and the best wings. You better take whatever wing you get when you get there. I'm not, hey, just fit me with some wings, God. All I need so I can fly around heaven all day. Oh, my God, Sister Ruth is in the building. Thank you, Sister Ruth. We've missed you. Yes, sir. And he took them up in his arms and put his hands upon them and blessed them. What is this dedication this morning all about? Young children are not of an age that they can make a decision to choose or reject Jesus. They don't have the cognitive ability to reason through an immaculate conception like the Virgin Mary experience. They can't imagine a Jesus that's God in three persons. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. They can't imagine a son coming down from heaven, walking around the earth for a while, and then allowing himself with all the power he had to be whipped all night long. A baby doesn't have those kinds of skills. They are dependent and needy, but they can't think through those in that kind of way. They can't imagine a Jesus that would be affixed to a cross, let people ridicule him all day long, talk about it. Even the thieves on either side of him were talking about it. They can't imagine how in the world could a person with that kind of power not just save himself and come down off of that cross. Well, this morning, I'm here to tell you I'm glad he stayed there. But they can't understand a Jesus staying there like that, and I'm sure, because they don't have anything called faith yet, that they can't understand how you could place a dead person in a tomb, put a rock up to the door, and on the third day morning, he comes out of that grave with all power in his hand. So what is this about this morning? This is about asking God to watch over and bless this child until that child reaches the age of reason so that that child then can make a decision to reject or accept Jesus. That's what this is about. This isn't about salvation, but I believe until that child reaches the age of reason or decision that Jesus will cover him or her with their blood. That's why we do this. They'll be covered by the blood of Jesus. And if something should befall them before they reach that age of decision, before they reach that age of reason, and they're taken from this land, I believe, according to the scripture, God's got them covered. I believe that they're covered at that point. But then, to the parents, grandparents, friends that are sitting here this morning, how are they going to learn about that Jesus? Unless you bring them where they're going to hear about Jesus. You need to wake up on a Sunday morning and say, not only do they need to know about Jesus, I need to know about Jesus, because if they don't come and learn, they're going to make the wrong decision. Chester would be in a better place today if mothers and fathers and uncles and aunts would bring children into the house of God so they can learn about Jesus and learn some respect for authority and learn some respect for mom and dad and learn that little song, Jesus Love Me, This I Know. For the Bible tells me no. So you have to bring them in order for them to learn. How many of you remember growing up in Sunday school and Bible school and vacation Bible school and those things that you thought were ridiculous back then? When you got down to your last dime, you remembered somebody named Moses that had his back pressed to the Red Sea, and God delivered him, opened up that Red Sea. He and all of his people walked through there on dry ground. And then when the enemy came behind him, they covered him up, and they moved on to the promised land. You don't learn that at home. You got to learn it right here at CCC. That sounds like a commercial, doesn't it? Well, I don't mind plugging the church I pastor. I don't think you can find a better church. I don't think you can find better people. I don't think you can find anything better than being right here at CCC. So after this dedication service, I want you to consider whether you need to make CCC your church home. Let's stand. We're done. We're done. After we extend the invitation, we're going to go immediately into the baby dedication service. I know some people think it's a baptism. It is not a baptism. The scripture said that he touched them. We're going to follow that pattern this morning. But if there's someone here today that has not yet accepted Jesus Christ as their Savior, you can do so right now. It is not complicated. People try to make it complicated. It's not complicated. It simply means that you've reached a point in your life where by faith you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God and that God raised him from the dead. The scripture says, thou shall be saved. Some of us have done that and walked away for a while. You can return today. We will welcome you with open arms. Many of us have made that decision from time to time to walk away and try it our way again. But we get the same results. You know why? You keep trying the same thing, the same way, you're going to get the same results. Annette and I used to have biscuit bake-offs. I tried the same thing all the time, never won a biscuit bake-off. As a matter of fact, my biscuits were so bad one Saturday morning, I took them out and threw them across the backyard. Only to know, I didn't know, but we were out there playing softball that afternoon. And I made a second batch of biscuits. And they said, here's Dad's first batch out here. He cheated. Well, y'all know me. But don't try the same thing over and over. You can come back right now. If you're looking for a church home, we invite you to the Christian Church of Chester. Yeah, we have our ups and downs, just like anybody, any church. And when folk run from here to somewhere else, they find something over there just like what they found here. So why don't you save yourself some energy? I'm talking to CCC now, and stay where you are. We're going to have our ups and downs. So the doors of the church are now open. If you would like to join us on this mission, why don't you come? There's time. Right now. Hey, how you doing? Why don't you come today? There's time. That was my test to see if he's going to cry. I think I passed the test. Why don't you come?
He will save. He will save.
Why don't you come today? There's time right now. There's time. You may be seated.
Life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me.
Can I have the parents, grandparents, godparents, family and friends of the baby to be dedicated this morning? Would you come forward, please? Okay, Father, it's right next to you. Grandparents, right here. Grandparents, any more grandparents? Great grandparents? Greats, great grandparent, come on right in here. Thank you, right there. Godparents, great great, come on up. Great great, godparents, come. You got to squeeze on in here. Okay, all right. That's okay. We're gonna widen the circle a little bit then. All right. Here we are. This is not just a formality. What we are literally doing is asking God's blessings upon Carson from this moment forward until he reaches the age of reason or decision. And then he'll be able to decide for himself what he thinks about this man called Jesus. And we are praying strongly that nothing happens to him between now and then. But should it happen, from this day forward, he will be covered by the blood of Jesus until he reaches that age of decision. To the great-great-grandparents, grandparents, give these young people of your wisdom and your knowledge. But trust me, this is their child to raise. Give them everything you know that will help. But at the end of the day, they will have to answer to God for what happens with Carson. To the godparent, years of knowledge and experience, share it willingly. Don't force it, just share it. For again, it's their responsibility to raise this child. Now, to the friends. In this day and age, it truly does take a village. It takes all of us to help Carson get an excellent start in life. We're depending on you. And go old school on Carson. If you see him doing something on the east side, but he lives on the west side, before he gets back to the west side, you better have a word to their parents. And trust me, in this day and age, parents don't like it and they might bawl you out. Take it in the best interest of the child. I know when I grew up in Huntsville, Texas, I never made it home before the story got there. We need to go back to those days. And finally, this is all for naught. Unless from this day forward you still start teaching him and bringing him to a place he can learn about Jesus. I know that there are a host of other religions out there. I believe in Jesus. I'm not ashamed of it. I preach Jesus. Born, buried, resurrected, and sitting on the right hand of God. So we're looking forward to it, parents. Before I leave, I want to read something good about Carson. So now we're going to attempt to do as Jesus did. Hello, my friend. How are you? Let us bow our head in a moment of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come today asking your choice blessings upon Carson. Keep him in your care. Build a hedgerow of protection around him.
never leave him nor forsake him. And we pray, God, that he will learn about your son, Jesus, that when he comes of the age of reason or decision, he will choose to follow Jesus. We believe, God, that you will watch over him, protect him, and guide him. Bless the parents, keep them strong. The world is ever changing, and we just want you to keep them strong. Bless all of the family, grandparents, great-grandparents, all of the family and friends, that they will help to raise this child in the proper way. This we say in Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Very good. God bless you. God bless you. Bless you. Amen. 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 In her usual style, Sister Ruth Friend brought a card for us to read. And she gave me instructions. She put a 1 on this side, a 2 on this side, and a 3 down here. So I think that's the order that she wants it read. To Pastor Lilly, Mrs. Lilly, and my church family, I give sincere thanks to everyone for remembering me and my family in so many ways during my illness. Your expressions of love through your cards, messages, offers to help us, generosity, and much, much more have truly been encouraging and helped me during my illness. Most of all, I'm grateful for your prayers, which I still desire. I love you all, especially miss the children. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver you out of my hands. God's word is true. Love and God bless you all. Ruth E. Hale's Friend. Thank you, Sister Ruth. We appreciate it. God bless you. Now, as you will recall, we have a meeting immediately following our service today. And we're going to give you 5 minutes to go out, refresh yourselves, come back in, because we will start the meeting immediately 5 minutes after you walk out that door. With or without you, we would like to have you here. Now, we're going to ask the young people if they have one more that will close out our service, and then we will immediately go into our meeting following this next selection after a 5-minute break. Thank you all for coming today.